Good day, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another What If video. In today's video, I want to unpack whether commission is included in the calculation of the national minimum wage. Now, in terms of the National Minimum Wage Act, an employer may not pay an employee less than the prescribed minimum wage for time worked. But what if an employee earns only commission or earns a basic salary plus commission, but the basic salary is less than the minimum wage? Can an employer pay an employee a basic salary, which is less than the minimum wage, or even no guaranteed basic salary, provided that the commission earned by the employee exceeds the minimum wage as prescribed by the Act? Now, to answer these questions, I will be referring to the recent Labour Court judgment in the matter between Atlas Finance versus the CCMA and others. Now, in this matter, the employees in question were all sales consultants of the employer and were employed on a basic salary plus commission calculated on a percentage of the value of new business generated per month during a 40-hour week. Now, in anticipation of the introduction of the national minimum wage, the employer proposed amending their contracts to include the amount of commission earned in their total package. Some sales representatives accepted the change, but the respondent employees were not happy. They referred the dispute to the CCMA, claiming that the employer was not complying with the National Minimum Wage Act. A commissioner found that the employer was not compliant and ordered the employer to pay employees just over 1 million rand as back pay and also imposed a proportional fine. Now, the employer was not happy with this and took the matter on review to the Labour Court, where it argued that the commission earned during working hours or normal working hours had to be included in the calculation of wages for purposes of the Minimum Wage Act, which was above the minimum wages. At the Labour Court, the Labour Court considered section 5.1, specifically subsection A to C of the National Minimum Wage Act, and found that commission is not part of the exclusions as listed in the Act. These exclusions are all discretionary payments. The court noted that the specification of ordinary hours is important because it excludes, for example, productivity or overtime. The court noted that in South Africa, wages are calculated based on ordinary hours worked, which ensures that employees receive payment for overtime work when applicable. Now, because the employees earned the commission during their working hours, the commission will not be seen as a discretionary payment, but form part of the employee's wages. The court held that if the legislator intended to exclude commission from the national minimum wage calculation, the legislator would have stipulated it specifically in the exclusions in Section 5 of the Act. Therefore, the court held that commission cannot be excluded when calculating the national minimum wage. So, ladies and gentlemen, just in conclusion, it should be noted that in terms of Section 5.3 of the Act, an employer is obliged to at least pay their employees the national minimum wage. If a commission worker or employee is not earning enough commission in a month, the employer should at least top up the employee's salary to comply with the minimum wage. That, ladies and gentlemen, brings us to the end of this video. Should you have any questions in this regard, please do not hesitate to contact us. As always, I will see you in 2 weeks' time. Bye-bye.